Now, what I wanted to say in this final video is that I think it's a damn shame and it's embarrassing and unfortunate that people will do anything for a little bit of attention and a couple of dollars in their pocket, because there was no reason for this to go down. It has to do with ego. It has to do with pride. And a lot of people are in this. And I did say that I had another theory about this, because it could be all of this is YouTube fantasy. Because Sara, Tariq, Cynthia G, Cheryl, Ratchet Today Show, and Tommy Sotomayor are all connected. They all have platforms to a degree, and they are all interconnected and know each other somehow. Now, my theory about this is, when Tariq confronted Tommy, I really feel like that was just so Tariq could get a one-up, right? Because Tariq and Tommy have been going back and forth and back and forth. Also, if you know, Polite and Tommy also had issues, right? So all of it, to me, could be interconnected in this YouTube world, because I've seen it happen on the white side of the YouTube community. And it seems like it could be that the black side of the YouTube community is trying to do the same. But with Polite, we all know they were making videos going after each other, and then all of a sudden they were supposed to debate, and then people were looking forward to this debate, and it was going to be heated and it was going to be intense. Nobody said it had to be disrespectful, but they were looking forward to that, and that's not what happened. And they so-called what squashed their little beef, they have disagreements or whatever, and it was supposed to be this way. They were never beefing in the first place. They probably got together and said, we're going to start this, make it look like a beef. We're going to go after each other. It's just like Tariq Nasheed and Tommy Sotomayor. I do not believe that they are not friends. Tommy and Tariq were cool, and they still are cool. Now, Tommy has been big for a while. He invited Tariq on the show and all of that. Tariq actually met with him because he knew that Tommy had a following in what he was doing. They were basically into the same thing, saying the same shit. So then he decided to do the pro-black thing, since Tommy had the black women bashing thing on lock. So he really couldn't be doing the same thing, or he would look like Feel the Advice show, which we can pull him into it, because he was doing the same thing like what Tommy was doing. But he decided to go into the pro-black news route, so he carved himself out. But before he did that, before he was so pro-black, he was talking about hood rats and making ratchet videos as well. You can go back and take a look at those videos. So he was trying to do the Tommy thing. Everybody knew Tommy had that on lock, so they decided to go over to the opposite side. So Tariq then started making these shows. They were going back and forth about what was being said. And then Tommy still had his following in all of his 151 channels. But then Tariq just suddenly came into the interview with Vlad, as if there wouldn't be security for the little white boy's safety. You kidding me? You think that wasn't planned? Come on. Bullshit if you think that wasn't planned. And then he went in there trying to talk tough. Tommy sat there and he was like, whatever. And then it made Tariq look tough, because right after that, you know, Tariq is going on these shows. You know, he had did a few shows a little bit before that, but then, you know, he met with Tucker Carlson and all. He was put up there more in the limelight, right? After the whole Tucker Carlson fail, Tommy kind of, you know, gained a little validity. He even tried to turn a corner as if he was trying to care. He couldn't really make that turn, but he tried to dabble in the I care about black people sector there, which he had to double his ass back because he knows that the majority of his white supremacist viewers would not be having that, and they are not going to support his ass. Tariq then started, you know, holding L's, and this is another L for him, so Tommy can capitalize off of this and other people can capitalize off of this. I mean, right after he supposedly let her go, which this could have been planned as well, this could have been scripted as well. Could have been, doesn't have to be, she could have been, you know, just used, but it's more like a scripted reality show where he's gonna fire her, make him look like the big man and the boss, make Tariq look like the big man and the boss, and then, oh, everybody gets a kick out of seeing the black woman get fired, and he handled that black woman, and all of these men are feeling good and they're donating and all of that, right? So she just happens to contact Cynthia G, which Tariq knows Cynthia G, and then she gets on the platform. She offers her a platform as if Cynthia G did not know that the dust bunnies were going to be all over the chat. Come on. And then all of a sudden, Cheryl decides to jump in and be there, and then Ratchet Today Show was in the corner over there waiting to talk about this, and everybody put everything on hold, and Cheryl, she just decided to moderate. I mean, she was put in a position where she didn't get enough shine. I feel like that's why she made that video, because her name really wasn't out there and she wasn't a part of it. So now she wants to make herself a part of it by questioning it. And she can keep her buddy-buddy relationship with Tariq and all that, saying, oh, I side with Tariq and all that. And then who knows what Cynthia G and Sarah will be doing, because they seem like they are edging towards Cynthia and Sarah have a similar personality or similar experiences. So yeah, that's how I see that. I mean, it could be one big fucking game just for everybody involved. Game. And the person that looks like they got left holding the short stick was Cheryl. Reason she made that video. But still, to me, it looks like just a big script. It could be just a big script, because all of this stuff happens out of the blue. He has been having problems with her all that time, if you believe what he said. I mean, everything just happens. You know, he fires her. She gets on Cynthia G. Cynthia agrees, even though we know that, you know, oh, Tariq, she loves Tariq. She just capes for Tariq. You know, she has the S on her chest and she comes to his defense at all times. But everybody is involved. Come on. I mean, there has been plenty. If you go over to the white side of YouTube, there is people that actually do YouTube news, and they say people call people and set shit up, pretend like they beefing, pretend like they have a problem with each other. This could be that, because I mean, Layla over there, she looked like she knew what was going down. It just didn't look like an out of the blue, sporadic, oh my God, you know, type thing. And it looked planned. Everybody is benefiting off of it. Tommy is benefiting off of it. He just happens to mention Tommy's name. What the hell does this have to do with Tommy in any type of way? Cynthia gets involved, which they know each other. You know, just, you know, that's something that I'm keeping in the back of my mind. Like, all this could be bullshit. It could be just for show. And then you have all of these people running from Tariq's show to Tommy's show to Cynthia's show to Cheryl's show to everybody who was involved. And now Sarah can have a platform where people are going to her after this just to see what she does, just to see what she says about Tariq. She gets a leg up as well. She gets, you know, she can get a lot of followers from this. And drop a comment, and I will see you in the next one.